Well, greetings, everyone. Well, for St. Patrick's Day, it's always great to have a nice black and tan. Today, we're going to be showing you how to make one. I'm not using the generally well-known ingredients, which is Guinness Stout, and then we also have usually Bass Ale as the beer that people prefer to use. But in this case, we're going to use something that's everyone sold out of that, so we're using something else called Guinness Blonde. Might as well keep it in the Guinness family. So I'm going to show you how to do this. A lot of people will tell you that you need a spoon like this to create the separation.
Well, but it's the other way around too, isn't it? Usually
you pour put the spoon in here and you're pouring it here. You put the light in first and then you make sure and drizzle it over the spoon. Okay. That's what everyone tells you. That's what you need to do. But I'm going to show you that you don't need to do that. And here's how you need to do it instead. We're going to open both these up first. There we go. All right. So first thing I'm going to do is take the lighter beer. If it's Bass Ale, that's what you're using. If it's Guinness Blonde, that's what you're using. Pour it into your glass, and I mean pour it in aggressively, okay? Because what you want is to get a nice head on this, about an inch, okay? And there's no spoon required because what happens is that this 1 inch of head is going to eventually is your barrier as you're pouring this in. So you don't need, and you don't want to just pour it straight in. You want to drizzle it. As you can see, I'm using a small circle here to pour this in. And I'm being very patient, especially at the beginning. At the very first stage of this, you want to be very, very slow and just work it in very slow. Bring this down as low as you can to the glass. And you can see that now I'm starting to get sort of a dark layer forming. We just have to be patient. Keep moving it around slowly. Using the whole area because you don't want to get a stream of flow into there because that will create it'll break the
barrier
if you will. So as you can see, I'm starting to get it just about like I want here. I'm trying to be nice and slow. I know this takes some time, but again, it can be done as you can easily see here. And once you start to get the dark beer, the stout building up a layer, so to speak, you can pour it a little bit faster as I'm starting to do now. But you want to start off at first very, very slowly. And that's how you do it, folks. Now I'm just going to continue. And happy St. Patrick's Day from me and my wife, Cheryl.
Hi. Do you use both full cans of the Guinness and the Blonde, or do you just use partial?
Well, what I'm using really is about a half a can of each.
Okay.
In this case, you can see now we've got a really nice little separation. We're about to finish it off.
So you could make another full one with what's left over almost, right?
Yes. I can actually get two. Okay. This one, you know, not quite with these tall glasses, but with a pint glass you can. So I hope you've enjoyed that. You can see it's easy to get the separation. Don't even have to use the old-fashioned spoon like they talk about. Thanks for tuning in, and we hope you've enjoyed it. Give a thumbs up if you liked it, and we'd appreciate it.